again my task for this morning lunch here in the Philippines and night for you, many of you in the US, is to maybe share some stories about our recent mission and maybe also from the last mission last December, which for us is a historic feat, particularly focusing on people power in the West Philippine Sea. Justice Carpio, in our last press conference, was the one who said this. He said that at the end of the day, what we're doing is not just a simple giving of gifts or giving of fuel, donations, supplies to our fellow Filipinos. It's building people power. But now, not on the streets, we're building it in the West Philippine Sea, which is one of the one of the an important space and an important platform where we need to build national unity around. So I'll probably just share for my presentation some photos. So just more storytelling. On the one hand, what did we do? And on the second, maybe some reflection points on what does it mean to build people power, especially on the issue of the West Philippines. So I already shared my presentation. I hope everyone can see it. Okay po. All
Yeah.
right. So let me start off by again showing you some photos, but also with a quote from the article that Olivia mentioned from Admiral Romel Jude Ong, retired officer from the Navy. In his article, Ating Itos Foray to Scarborough Shoal, A Quest for the Filipinos' Theory of Victory, he said, and he quoted one of the things he posted on LinkedIn, that there is only one word to describe what is in the mind of a major power, a superpower, China, that amasses a fleet mobilizing an armada of 44 military vessels. We're not even counting the dark ships. Because they usually deploy dark ships or untraceable ships to play goalkeeper in a small atoll against a squadron of wooden fishing boats manned by civilians. And that one word is fear. It seems like in the last effort by Filipinos to show China that will not be bullied, it's not us who were cowed to fear. Hindi po tayo ang nasindak. Mukhang ang nasindak ay China. Imagine sa harap ng wooden fishing vessels, they would send an armada of metal big giant ships. And that, I suppose, is the premise of people power. At the end of the day, China is more, they understand military power. But in the face of people power, it seems like they don't know how to respond. They are dumbfounded how a group of a ragtag team and a 200 or so civilians would brave to face Chinese Navy ships. And I think that it's really something that for them is also a surprise. Para po tayong ano, a thorn on their side. Parang napuwing natin sila, sa liit natin, napuwing natin ng isang superpower. And that for us is the potential of people power, civilian power in the face of military power. So in last year, around August, we started this journey. A lot of the conversations came before that. Finally, we were able to launch and come together as a loose coalition of different organizations, groups. These groups were friends even before the coalition was formed. And the campaign for the West Philippine Sea is all over a decades long. But during that time, last year, we were thinking, what can we do something? Is there something new that we can offer? Especially at a time when we're seeing even more so how China has been doing water cannon against our Filipino vessels. And the sense of frustration is there. And these groups of individuals, Sir Ed, a lot of the other convening organizations, were having conversations. What can we do, ordinary citizens, especially in the face of big Chinese vessels? And the idea of Maybe we should go there. Maybe we should. We can. Christmas is just around the corner. Maybe we can bring gifts to the fisher folk and frontliners there. We can go to BRP Sierra Madre and just BRP and give supplies there. So the idea was, it seemed simple and also, you know, in my mind, and I was one of the first skeptics. Are we crazy? We're gonna go there and face the Chinese vessels? But you know, the idea soon caught fire. People was like, we're like, come on, let's try to do it and just see what happens. And we were finally able to launch again last August, together with BRRM, Carrot, PKSK, Pakisama, artists and designers also came with us along with other fisherfolk organizations and groups. The goal of the of Atin Ito was basically to normalize civilian voyages in the West Philippine Sea. The idea was, if the West Philippine Sea is ours, if that is our exclusive economic zone, then we should be able to go there freely and claim our exclusive economic zone, our sovereign rights to our PEC. And what we were saying then was, for each act of Chinese aggression, then the Philippines should mount and respond with more supply missions. Again, more civilian activities in the area. We've always been saying, if China is militarizing the area, our goal is to civilianize it. Make sure that it's not the military presence overwhelming in the area, but the civilian presence should be, if not equal, even more, to ensure that we Filipinos are the one really, you know, enjoying the fruits of our own seas. And finally, and again, this did not come without much preparation, even tit for tat with the national government, we were able to mount the historic mission last December in time for Christmas. I wasn't able to put a photo. I was meaning to put a photo right before this mission. We had a PR war with the National Task Force on the West Philippine Sea because ADG Malaya, along with the other members of the task force, were discouraging us to go there. But we were telling them, but we are not asking for permission, because at the end of the day, again, this is our easy. We ordinary citizens should be able to go there. And then finally, we were able to find common ground and find a plan in such a way that, okay, if we cannot stop you, we need to make sure at least that you're safe. And finally, again, understood that we were again on the same team, the Filipino team against the Chinese bully that we're facing. And for this mission, we were joined by 40 fishing vessels as part of the convoy, but we boarded a big training ship. During that time, we were lucky to get AMUSUP, a local union, to give us access to a training ship that would join us. But in the morning of our first day, China was already there waiting for us and conducted shadowing activities. At a certain point, they conducted dangerous maneuvers, even cutting us from our Philippine Coast Guard escort. So here in this photo, you can see the Chinese Coast Guard cutting us and the Philippine Coast Guard farther away, because the Coast Guard then, I think it was BRP Gabriela Silang that joined us, and they made sure that we were safe. But the Chinese Coast Guard again was doing dangerous maneuvers, even cutting our convoy. But it wasn't actually the Chinese Coast Guard that first met with us. It was a Chinese Navy ship that first came to view and passed us by, which was an unusual, which we found out was quite unusual. Usually it's the Chinese militia ship or the Coast Guard that usually does the shadowing. But for us, a civilian convoy, it was a Chinese destroyer, a Chinese Navy ship, a warship that first started shadowing us. Again, a clear attempt to intimidate our vessel. And even if they were not we were not able to go to our destination, we were quite lucky, and in a way it was a fortuitous event that our supply boat was able to you know, in Filipino nakalusot, it was able to pass the Chinese blockade and get to our intended destination, Lawak Island, and give the needed supplies of the frontliners in Lawak Islands. So this was our first foray last year, last December, where again we see Filipino discarte, making sure that at the end of the day, even if the main convoy was not able to go, we have a smaller supply vessel that was able to go there. But we did not want to stop there. So again, it was historic. It was the first time that we had a civilian supply mission in the West Philippine Sea, in Ayungin Shoal. We knew we wanted to do a second mission right after we did the first one. Because again, the idea was we wanted to regularize, normalize civilian access in the West Philippine Sea. So this early May, we conducted a press conference announcing our plans that we will now focus on Bajo de Masinloc, so facing Zambales, with centering our civilian mission on the plight of the fisher folk in the area. Because as we know, Chinese vessels have been shooing away our fisher folk in the area, so they're not able to fish anymore freely in Bajo de Masinloc, especially inside the shoal in the lagoon area where yung Yamang Dagat, the catch is quite rich. And we launched it just last week, so it's quite fresh. Some of the photos here are quite fresh. Maybe some of you have seen this on Facebook as well. And our volunteers was composed of young people, religious groups, even some foreign observers. We had three priests, we had two doctors, we had two medics to make sure that everyone was safe. Again, ordinary citizens coming together. We even had some members of the LGBT community join us, some vloggers and influencers again joining the mission. This time around, we boarded fishing vessels. So this is one of the pictures of the fishing vessels where we boarded together with other fishermen joining the convoy. We were a bit more ambitious. We wanted a convoy of 100 fishing vessels, and we were proud to say that we were able to do our first mission objective, which was to conduct a regatta, a peaceful parade of fishing vessels going to our own exclusive economic zone. So here in the photo, you can see a drone shot of our successful regatta or peaceful parade in our own EEZ. This was our way of showing China that we are united and all Filipinos are together, standing up to China, up in arms, magkakapit bisig, but this time around, showing boats together in our parade. Our second mission for this, or our second objective for this second mission, to put symbolic markers with you know, floating buoys or boyas, where it's written WPS atin ito. So in the floaters, you can see there WPS atin ito. Again, to show China loud and clear so that they can hear that the Filipino people are united in saying that the West Philippine Sea is ours. And of course, the most important objective of this mission is to provide fuel and food supplies to our fisher folk in the area. For this mission, we had three layers of supply mission. One, we were able to give fuel and supplies to the fisher folk who joined the convoy. A second round is going to the Bajo de Masinloc. The fisher folk that are there conducting month-long, week-long fishing activities, we were able to give them fuel and food supplies as well. But more importantly, and this is for us one of the highlights of the second mission, our supply boat, which went a day before, was able to breach China's illegal and massive illegal blockade in the Bajo Masinloc. it was able to reach as far as 20 nautical miles away from Bajo de Masinloc, where it was able to give fuel and food packs to those who are actually fishing in the shoal. So this is our third round, which is actually the first kasi this came first, of giving fuel and food packs to those to the fisher folk who are in the area. Again, many of them fish days at a time. Some would even take weeks and even months because they need to make sure that they have enough catch to bring home. They would actually say that before it will only take them a few days, but now because of China, they have to stay there longer. And look for other fishing grounds. And that's why these refueling missions are important to make sure that they are able to really conduct fishing activities in the area effectively. One bonus objective of this mission is for our volunteers to also experience fishing in the area. So we were also able to experience, in solidarity with the fisher folk there, how it commercial fishing vessels do their payaw fishing. So dito po sa picture, makikita ninyo some of our volunteers also helping out. Being in solidarity, nakikiisa doon sa ating mga mangingisda. In this photo, I want to shout out, yung nasa pinakakaliwa, this is our captain in the boat where I was in, si Cap Totoy. Some of the people who really gave us a sense of stability and security during the mission was actually our boat captains. Because in the face of Chinese shadowing, they were there giving us a sense of peace. Kampante yung pakiramdam namin because we knew we were taken care of by the fisher folk who hosted us. And while we were doing all of this, the symbolic markers, the fishing activities, the regatta, we were already being shadowed by three Chinese coast guards and at a certain point by a Chinese Navy ship. Our advance party, our advance boat, was also shadowed by a Chinese Navy ship, so a warship and a helicopter. And some of the media were even telling us that at night, you can see all of the drones trying to take pictures of us. Trying to intimidate us. But we were undeterred. We continued with our activities. And the tip of our spear, the supply boat, was even able to breach the illegal blockade of China. But I just want to say that this mission, and we're proud of the success of this mission, did not happen in a vacuum. There was a lot of preparation going to the civilian voyage, which I also want to share with you. So ito na po yung ilang mga activities pa that we had to do to prepare the groundwork, to prepare the narrative as well. Because we needed to make sure that when we go there, we also bring together with us the support of the Filipino people. And that involves conducting concerts with artists. We had not just Noel Cabangon, Ototelic, other artists joined us in this concert last December. We conducted activities with the fisher folk communities in the area during Christmas time as well, giving gifts not just to the frontliners but also to the fisher folk. Had an exhibit and a film showing. So I will breeze through some of the photos because I want to go to the last part of this presentation. So we also had a school caravan. So we've been jumping from school to school to make sure young people understand the issue. And we're proud to say even high school students understand EEZ. They hear it on the news and they're quite interested in what is happening in the West Philippine Sea. So much so that a high school, even they mounted a school play on the West Philippine Sea. And this was done independently of us. We were just so happy that they linked up with us, invited us to their play, and had us conduct a forum with them as well. Again, young people also doing their part. And of course, our broad support of donors also. Because at the end of the day, we need to bring supplies there. And the supplies come from our donors, small and big. Special mention to Sir Al Mayoralgo, who's heading the Makati Villages Council. He really went the extra effort, even sharing the word and raising supplies. And also, of course, to Gitan, who also chipped in so that we can bring the needed supplies to our fisher folk. But just some final reflection points on how it's important to really build people power and the different elements that come together in building it. At the end of the day, the invitation is to make sure that all hands are on deck. People from different walks of life, different sectors should come together to build this. And it's not just Akbayan or PRRM. It's a lot of different groups coming together. And I start this reflection just by identifying some of the elements that came together. The first one, I think, is the power of an idea. For us, the civilian mission was powerful because it was a simple idea. Filipinos should be able to go there. Fisher folk should be able to go there. It's a simple idea, to be honest. We should be free to go there. And an idea, when planted, and it's, you know, pag umusbong, it bears fruit. And hopefully, it catches on. It catches fire. So people now go there and try to show it on social media. I'm here at the West Philippine Sea. Just after our mission, there was a tourist who went there and just, you know, just in a bikini, swam there near Pag-asa Island, showing that tourism can happen in the West Philippine Sea. Again, a simple idea. And as I told you earlier, I was one of the skeptics in the beginning. Like, are we crazy? Are we really going there? But, you know, it was the power of a simple idea that, again, when adopted by so many people and accepted, can be powerful enough to you know, push China to also be afraid of what this idea can bring. Just imagine. And this idea has even caught fire, not just in the Philippines, even neighboring countries are already, we've been hearing that neighboring countries are also thinking that maybe they can do another similar activity like this, civilian missions by, I don't know, Vietnam, Indonesia, Malaysia, ordinary citizens as well, going to our own exclusive economic zone. The idea from Admiral Ong's article again, he said, it's a spirited effort to civilianize our exclusive economic zone and counter China's militarization. The idea, while simple, is actually the opposite of what China is doing. If China is militarizing the area, it's expanding their military presence in the area. The necessary response is to displace their military presence by civilian presence. So it's a simple idea, but it's the counter argument to what China is actually doing. And for us, that's again potent and powerful. And by civilianizing the area, we actually reclaim agency. We're now the primary player. Ordinary citizens are the primary player. We're not on the sidelines. We're not watching the news. We are the primary player, and we need to make sure that we come together to actually claim that space and to claim agency and enjoy the benefits of our own seas. We also understand that the crucial to this mission is the power of the community of voyagers. We won't be able to mount this without the bravery of our volunteers who actually joined our mission. In the beginning, we were also wondering, are people gonna say yes? Are they gonna join us? By the second mission, people, random strangers, were emailing us, were messaging us on Facebook saying, hey, we wanna join, we wanna be part of your mission. It all already came to a point that we had to say, maybe next time, because we can't accommodate any more people on the boats for safety reasons as well. But again, it was the power of building communities of Filipinos who are willing to brave the seas for our mission. And it's not just the people who went there. The community involves all of the different people who at one point contributed to the mission. It's also the power of collective leadership. We know that this plan came from a core group of people from PRRM, Akbayan, and other conveners of Atin Ito. But we knew that planning it will have to We'll have to bring in people who understand the area. And special mention po dito, yung captains of the boat. So here we were already celebrating. This was already after the mission. We had a dinner with some of our boat captains who was with us. And the plan from the route that we took to the advance mission that we had to design, all of those things, we had to plan it with our captains. And for us, this was so important because the ownership of the mission was also shared. And the planning stage and even the idea of fishing together came from our boat captains. So we knew that leading this mission should be a shared endeavor by many of the people who were crucial to the mission as well. And also, yung discarding Pinoy was for us crucial as well. Parte po dito yung makikipagpatintero ba tayo doon sa armada nila na almost 50 Chinese vessels na metal, malalaki, gigantic. Kasi kapag pumasok tayo sa larangan na yon, if we play by their rules, at makikipagpatintero tayo doon, talo tayo. So we knew we had to make our own diskarte na mananalo at we ensure that we win our mission objectives. Kaya po talagang when we were planning this, we were mindful na dapat may diskarte tayo na talagang pasok din dun sa pasok sa expertise natin pero labas sa expertise ng China. Kasi sanay sila dun sa malaki military might. Dami at yung military strategy nila ng blockade, but we knew that yung the power of smallness as well, and we need to maximize our strength and in a way use our weakness to our advantage, kasi maliit yung boat natin, hindi mapapansin ang tingin nila dyan, fishing vessel din. So parang ito yung sinasabi ng isang kaibigan natin na political judo. We use their strength against them in the same way, what they think as a weakness para sa atin can also be our strength. At ito yung diniskartehan po natin para siguradong at the end of the day, mananalo natin, maipapanalo natin yung ating mission. We also were really thankful for the power of faith. Para sa atin, sobrang importante ng faith in this mission. Yung people power for many of us who participated po siguro in the past, nung 80s, even then, parte ng ating struggle, yung ating pananampalataya. So when we went through this mission, clear for us that we were also commemorating and celebrating Stella Maris, Mary Star of the Sea, na dinadasalan ng ating mga voyagers. And we were thankful to have the presence of Father Robert Reyes and other foreign priests who joined us. Ito po, hindi to planado. This was not part of the plan, but the priests offered that we had a mass together before the voyage. And Father Robert asked for all of the fisher folk to come together, yung 100 po na naglayag kasama namin, so that they can bless them. It was such a powerful moment. And it was so unplanned. And the fisher folk there holding Stella Maris, ito po yung, you can see Mama Mary holding a star. It was for us, it prepared us for the voyage. Because this was the night before the voyage. Halong kaba, halong tapang. And in the spirit of prayer, naramdaman namin na magkakasama kami. And it really set the tone of the voyage. Again, rooted in our faith and pananampalataya. This also mirrors what we did last December. Nung nakaraang December po, hindi ko nabanggit kanina, nag-start yung Chinese shadowing while we were doing Holy Mass in the ship. So makikita nyo po in the left picture, nagmimisa kami, doon sa backdrop, kitang-kita mo yung Chinese vessel na nagsisimula na, lurking in the horizon. But people were again undeterred kasi parang napalakas yung loob namin habang kami ay in the spirit of prayer. We ended this last mission also in prayer. So bago po kami bumalik, we offered 17 medallions of the Immaculate Conception consecrating the oceans or the West Philippine Sea. Also synchronized with the different boats. May kwento pa po yan eh, kasi si Father Robert muntik malunod. So may mga ilan po sa aming nag-swimming in the area. Pero later na lang po siguro sa open forum yon. Also, the power of stories. Very crucial po in this mission that we tell the story. It cannot be done in the dark of night. Kasi kapag hindi namin siya kinikwento, hindi siya magiging it will not have the same impact as it had. And for us, the story was clear. It was a story of David versus Goliath. And that was an important metaphor so that people from not just in the Philippines, pero even abroad, understand the disparity of power. And claro, ano yung kwento? Again, the power of stories and telling that story beyond the power of David and Goliath. And storytelling comes in different forms. Marami po tayong nakasama in this mission, inside the mission and outside the mission, who created art inspired by the mission and inspired by the struggle. So ito po, ito lang to, this week, there's an art exhibit. Artists also coming together, creating, really thought-provoking, emotional pieces also to tell this story. Of a David versus a Goliath, a small boat and a dragon, no? Social media, digital artists as well, telling our story. Ito po sa kaliwa, Banana Cute. Gumawa sila ng mga cartoon version ng ating mission. We also have other storytellers from international observers. Lucky po tayo kasi may kasama tayo from Sri Lanka, Pakistan, and Sweden. Kinikwento rin po nila yung kwento natin to other audiences. And of course, the media, who were there the whole time. Sa totoo lang po, itong kwento na ito, hindi namin makikwento kung hindi rin sumama maglayag yung mga kasama sa media. So it was important that we had, the role of the media is so important in telling this story. And finally, the audacity of courage. At the end of the day, we won't be able to do this kung hindi po tayo naghawaan ng katapangan. This photo is by one of our boat leaders, si Robert Garcia. Some of you might know him. This was also a spur in the moment. I-flash mo nga yung Philippine flag against the Chinese Coast Guard. And he did. And this became one of the iconic photos of the mission. The bravery of the individual and the bravery of the collective coming together in the face of China. As a final notes, final few slides, I go back to Admiral Ong's article where he said, at the end of the day, we need to find what is victory for us. Ano ang panalo for us? Ano ang tagumpay para sa atin? Kasi sa China, klaro yun. Sa China, they have what they call Red Theory of Victory, according to Brad Roberts. Their red theory of victory is premised on exploiting divisions. Hati-hatiin tayo. Hatiin yung mga kalaban niya. To exploit divisions among China's adversaries and in persuading them to give up in our claim, our interest to avoid escalation. So papaniwalain tayo na mag-e-escalate. So wag na lang kayo magsalita. Tumahimik na lang kayo. Keep silent so that you don't escalate the tension and exploit the divisions around us. And this is so clear in Philippine politics right now. The division between our political leaders is so clear. They're exploiting that. It's such a teleserye, just watching our political leaders bicker. More, even heartbreaking, exploiting divisions among our fisher folk. And that for me is even more heartbreaking. Kasi even po among fisherfolk communities, they would say, nako, kapag tumindig kayo, if you stand up, you won't be able to fish here. Everyone's affected. So fisherfolk bickering that let's not antagonize China anymore. So they will allow us to go there. Allow us to go in our own West Philippine Sea. So exploiting divisions across the different sectors of society, even among our fisher folk. And we need to be mindful of that. Kasi kung yung mga mangingisda mismo natin ang pinaghahati nila, sila po yung nasa front lines. Kapag hindi na sila titindig para sa mga in their own traditional fishing grounds, para lang payagan sila ng China na mangisda doon, matatalo po tayo. So we can't allow them to exploit the divisions that exist within Philippines, the Philippines, and to persuade us to stay silent. Because in the face of Chinese bullying, we believe it's a moral obligation for us to speak truth to power. The challenge again, and this is the quote from earlier, is for us to find ano yung national, ito yung challenge ni Admiral Ong sa amin, ano yung Filipino theory of victory? For us, ano yung panalo? At baka it's something that we still need to find. What is victory for us? For me, victory is when fisherfolk are able to fish there without any threat and without any permission from any other superpower. Because we will only achieve this through constant struggle, peaceful struggle. Ito pong ginagawa natin, mapayapang paraan ng pagtindig. Kung ang China, kaya niya ang puwersa, tayo, ang puwersa meron tayo, puwersa ng ordinaryong mamamayan. Again, people power. Through constant but peaceful means, we use different tools. We do not use the tools that Chinese are doing. Hindi the military tools that they use, but again, the tools of faith, the tools of courage, the tools of bayanihan, nagbibigayan tayo, nagtutulungan. Finally, ito po yung itong isa sa mga next steps ng ating ito, kasi nga po gusto nating tulungan yung mga mangingisda natin. We're thinking of also making sure na yung pagbabayanihan mas sustainable. Even hindi lang one time big time magbigay ng donasyon, pero magbigay ng ito po yung payaw. Malaki yung tulong nito to make sure na maganda ang catch ng mga mangingisda namin. So we're actually launching an adopt a payaw system later on. More details to follow, para yung mga fisher folk doon, lalo na po yung mga maliliit, yung mga artisanal at saka yung mga individuals, hindi yung mga commercial fishing vessels, meron silang access sana to payaw as well. So yun po siguro, I end with that. At the end of the day, again, ang tagumpay sa atin ay tagumpay ng ordinaryong mamamayan na kayang malayang makapaglayag, malayang makapangisda sa sarili nating karagatan. Maraming salamat po.